is my house.
Your house?
I was born here. My father killed himself here. Now it belongs to me. When you were married to Blake, you must have seen this house on at least one occasion.
When I was married to Blake, the servants came to my house. I didn't go to this.
Well, now is your chance. We're going to talk, and this is where we're going to do it. Feels so empty, doesn't it? It's felt like this ever since my mother left and my father went to live in the mansion with you and Blake. Wonder if he took that emptiness with him.
I haven't the slightest idea.
You were there. Did he spend his nights alone in his room?
Look, Kirby, I really don't want to talk about this.
Were his days empty? Did you notice? Did you care?
Let's talk about Paris. I have no intention of discussing your dead father.
Oh. Dead. When did he die? Was it here or years ago bowing and scraping to you?
Look, this is absolutely ridiculous. I don't have to answer to you any more than I have to answer for Joseph.
Then who do you have to answer to? There has to be someone somewhere to whom you're accountable.
I don't know what you're talking about. Now, I came here to talk about my job offer to you in Paris. If you don't want to discuss that, then I'm leaving. You've got something to sell. Talk to her.
I'm not selling, lady. I'm part of the neighborhood watch. I know there's nobody supposed to be living here, and after I saw the car outside, I thought I'd better check it out. What are you doing here? How'd you get the key?
I'm the owner.
You thinking about buying the place?
Oh, my good man, you must be joking. No, but you could do me an enormous favor. If you could just show me where the nearest phone is, I'd like to call for a taxi.
Miss Coley.
Yes, Douglas.
Miss Kendall's waiting for you in your office. She said she had a 10 o'clock appointment with you. And I'm Jerome.
Well, Jerome, in the brief time that you may be working for me, no one is allowed in my office unless I give specific approval. Mrs. Colby. Miss Kendall. Please sit down.
Thank you.
I've been informed by an acquaintance that Blake Carrington's fired you and you're looking for another job.
Well, as a matter of fact, I've been thinking of leaving for some time.
I suppose I should ask why you were fired, but knowing my ex-husband and the inordinate value he places on his wife's limited talents, I'm not surprised he got rid of you.
Well, it was mutually agreed that I should leave.
Of course it was.
Mrs. Colby, I'm not looking for just any job. I'm very talented. And I admire your business sense, your position in the community. I can't think of anybody that I'd rather work for.
I also happen to compete with Blake Carrington. So if you're here to get revenge...
Okay, let's be honest.
Okay, let's. That's why you're here, isn't it?
Well, why don't we put it this way? I had access to Denver Carrington's confidential files. I know things that others, including you, do not. Now, should you hire me, my loyalty would obviously go to Colby Co.
Miss Kendall, people who have secrets to sell have only one loyalty, and that's to money. Now, you're willing to sell out Blake Carrington. What guarantee do I have that given the opportunity, you wouldn't be willing to sell me out, too?
You know, I read where you once said, life holds no guarantees. You can relax, Dex. I got the job.